We're starting to come up on the holiday season, with a holiday of hopes in Christmas and a holiday of dreams in New Year's Eve. So, I thought it might be fun to go over some of my personal hopes and dreams for the future. That's it, that's the video concept. Transition! YouTube. No, I'm just kidding. YouTube is one of them. However, I also have a dream to start an animation and gaming studio. Basically, I want where it would be online, kind of like an e-studio, I guess you could say. And we would just work on games. Work on games and animations. Not really more than that. Basically, I love coming up with ideas for shows and games. But if I were to actually go and acquire all the skills it would take to do it all myself, then it would end up, then I just feel like the overall product would suffer. Because it's much better to have a group, to have a person, each people, that can do their group or team people, that can do each job really, really well. After all, it's there is that one quote that says, the jack of all trades, master of none. Well, if we can get some masters in there of some of the things and just gather all the masters, then we almost have a guaranteed good product. And so those are basically the two main businesses that I want for my dream career, is being the head of an animation and gaming studio, which, by the way, I wouldn't just do my ideas. I would also hand the baton over to the other workers other people, and be like, hey, let's make some of your ideas if you have any. Because it's not all about me. It's a team effort. So we gotta work on it as a team. But yeah, and then YouTube. Because I really do love making videos for you guys. And yeah. So those would be my two careers. And essentially, for the game studio, I don't have like all the work ethics lined out. But you know, I just feel like if we're the opposite of Activision, I think we'll be doing good. Just do everything the opposite of the way Activision does it. And I think we'll be great. And here it is. Going around, a few things probably stick out. I added medieval castle-style towers on the corners to try and add some visual flair. And because I like the style of castles and the whole idea of clashing the traditional past with the modern comforts. Also, the gate around the house is meant to represent a sort of protective gate, but with the limitations of Minecraft, look more like a prison, so there's that. Moving inside now, we have the entryway, which as you can see has a place for your shoes and an overhang to put your coats. Then we enter into the living room, where we have my attempt at making something look like a flat screen TV and a couch. Just a chill living room with tons of space and maybe bigger furniture, and just space to relax and move around. And right here we have my PC, this way I can work on videos or anything else I need to work on, while still being with my lover or guest, and it also just feels better to me to be working out in the living room instead of in a cornered off room or studio separate from everything else. Anyway, we continue to the dining room, which I don't think we would have a table this big necessarily, but you never know what we may need. Moving on to the kitchen, we have the standard. Plenty of counter space, an oven, cupboards, and obviously we would have the standard appliances like a blender, microwave, and air fryer. But it's hard making that stuff in Minecraft. Now we have the deep freezer. We would have a normal fridge as well, but for when we need to store things for a while, because I like to shop in advance, we have the deep freezer. And here we have the bedroom. As you can see, there is a giant bed there. I'd assume king size, maybe, if I were to say what size it would end up being. And then over here we have a giant walk-in type of closet for both mine and my lover's eventual clothes. And then also a place in the bottom for shoes. A little bit of heart designs on the tower up, which you'll see that in a moment. But here we have the private bathroom. I almost said bedroom. But we have the private bathroom. And then if we go up these stairs, it will lead to a little secret. I struggled to get up the stairs a little bit. That was my bad. But here we have the secret spot, as I like to call it, where it's just a secret spot just for us to go to. The carpet's meant to be sort of like padding, so it would be like soft so we could lay on it and stuff. And yeah. So now we're going to be moving on to the guest bathroom right here. I had to remember which one. But yeah, this is the guest bathroom. Like I said, nothing special about it. Or not like I said, but you know what I mean. Just standard. And up here we have the attic. Which is, of course, your standard attic. Just a space to store stuff that we don't want to put in the basement or anywhere else. And speaking of the basement, let's head there now, why don't we? So it's just going to be straight through this door and then down the steps. We'll go upstairs in a moment so I can show you what's up there as well. But this is the basement. Again, just a place to store stuff. Obviously, there would be maybe a generator here. Obviously, the water heater. But that's just that sort of stuff. But now, if we go the opposite way and head upstairs instead of down, we have the sort of rooftop balcony, as I like to call it. Where this would be more of a public, similar to the other one, this would be just be more of a public place. So if we wanted to have a cool place for, like, a grill out or something, we could just move it all up here. Or have people come up there. And now we are heading to... And now we're going to show you the backyard, because that's pretty much everything inside of the house. So, going into the backyard here, we have the pool. Which, obviously, the actual pool itself I would make bigger. But I didn't exactly plan everything about the yard when I started doing this, so I just kind of plopped things down and things kind of went nuts. Just because I wasn't planning right. But anyway, and then over here we have what would be a kind of tool shed for things like shovels, lawnmowers, all that sort of stuff. Woodworking would probably go in here, so that way it's not like getting sawdust and stuff all over the house if I were to ever do that. But yeah, that is pretty much it. This is my dream house. I would really like to hear what you think about it in the comments below. But yeah, so let's move on.
Hush, hush, blush, blush, blush.
You are now my...
Obviously, everyone has the ideal partner in their minds. Someone they dream up to be their perfect soulmate. And here is mine. I know. She is 2D and not 3D like most girls, but once you meet her, I'm sure you'll agree her personality is absolutely amazing. Wait, what? That's a guy? You sure about that? Oh. Well, I'm fucked. Good thing that was just a little joke for you guys. My actual dream girl is the one I'm dating. So please don't cancel me. I don't try to get pronouns wrong, I swear.
And with that, it's time for me to head off. Remember to like the video if you enjoyed it. And while you're down there, why not leave a comment with your thoughts? If you want to support me, I have a $1 and $5 tier on Patreon. The $1 tier gets your name at the end of each video, in the corner there, in the Patreon corner. And for $5, you get an avatar displayed on screen at the top, along with me saying your name out loud, like... Or, of course, you can support me for free by subscribing down below. And last but not least, I would like you all to remember to stay awesome!